Man, look at that. I'm already sweating.
It's been about 12, almost 13 minutes. Whew.
Big D Keto here. Came back from the gym. I did like a 2-hour workout, full body workout. I did a fasted cardio and had a good workout today. It was really good, you know. For the past week, I haven't been going to the gym lately because, you know, I've just been tired. And I went to my friend's birthday party on Saturday, you know, so I took a couple days off from the gym, you know, just to relax and rest and stuff like that. So anyways, one thing I want to talk about in this video is the weight scale. You know, this can be a little discouraging, you know, sometimes. Like for me, from my experience, like my weight fluctuates between like 255 to 260, you know, and kind of in the plateau. Like I step on the scale and I'm like, okay, all right, like I'm at 260, but then again I feel like I feel a lot slimmer than 260, you know. Nonetheless, like I feel a lot better. Like my clothes fits me a lot better. I even have people from work and friends tell me that, like, they can see a big difference. I lost a lot of the weight. You mean? So like, what I'm trying to say is that, like, don't depend on the scale. because sometimes it's not accurate. Actually, most of the time it's not accurate because, you know, you're building muscle, and my diet, I mean, is moderate protein, high fats, you know, because I believe that the weight scale doesn't, it cannot calculate your body fat percentage, your muscle mass index. Like, at the same time, like, I'm doing my keto diet, and I'm building muscle too. I'm working out at the gym, I'm lifting weights, and I'm doing cardio. But then again, I do want to confess something, that I believe I do need to work on my cardio a little bit more, like going on the treadmill. Like, to be honest, like, the treadmill is not really my best friend, you know. There's like ways and like strategies to run on the treadmill, and like I did today, like for like a minute I did like a 2 speed for like 1 minute, and the next minute I did like 3 speed, and next minute keep going up the speed until I reached like 6 speed on the treadmill, and I was really like jogging really fast, you know. I did up like 2 reps of that, if that makes any sense. But after the workout, man, I mean I was sweating, I was breathing hard. So after the cardio, I did my workout routines that I normally do at the gym, and I felt pretty good, you know. Came home, I weighed myself, now I'm like at 259. I mean, like I say, like I have a friend, he has a YouTube channel, If You're Keto, so I'll put his channel link in my description. So I mean, he kind of talked about the struggle, the keto struggle, but I kind of want to touch base on what he said. The weight scale could be really evil, you know, it could be really discouraging. But what I noticed that for me, like even though the weight scale doesn't, numbers is not what I want to see, but I see the big difference by the clothes I wear, the way I look, and how my body definition looks and feels. And because honestly, I'm building muscle at the same time, and I can't really depend on the scale like I want to. I could use the scale just to track where I'm at, you know, just don't get sidetracked. But then again, I have to realize that the scale doesn't determine how I feel, because sometimes like I step on the scale and I feel a little discouraged, like, dang it, man, like all week I worked hard at the gym, you know, my diet is on point. But then again, I can't let that discourage me and ruin my day. Find strategies to like to take the next step in a way. Like for me, I could honestly say that I am more active than I was 3 months ago. When I was at 312 pounds, I really did nothing all day. I'm home, sleep, and eat, sleep, and shit. Eat, sleep, all day. Eating, constantly. Since I discovered keto, you mean, I can honestly say that keto is the best way for weight loss. And really, I have lost all that weight. I feel better, I'm more active now. And one of my main diets is that I cut off sodas, sugar. And even to this day, I stopped drinking soda. On like a rare occasion, like let's say like my job had like a luncheon, or I'll drink like a Zero Coke or like a diet soda, but that's pretty much as far as I will go. Ultimately, I drink water, sparkling water. Like I drink the bubbly sparkling water, the Pellegrino water, and the little Coigs water. They're pretty good. I like those a lot too, and it doesn't really break your fast. So most of the time I do. Now I'm at the state of eating 1 meal a day, and the rest of the day I fast. So I probably won't eat till tomorrow. I came home from work and I ate around like 4 o'clock, ate some eggs and my little keto meal, and took a nap, woke up like at 9 o'clock, did a little bit of back and chest, mostly cardio, because I really wanted to really nip in the bud, like really speed up my metabolism, speed up my speed, like my cardio. The summer's here, so I need to really like stay on track. So the question is, should I depend on the weight scale? Yes and no. I personally will use the scale just to see where I'm at, but that number doesn't really define of who I am. That number doesn't define where I'm at in my body, how I feel, how I look, because when it comes down to it, the clothes you wear makes a big difference. and the pants I used to wear don't fit me no more, and the t-shirt I used to wear, Star Wars t-shirt, and that was like my favorite t-shirt, and like now, like when I put it on, it's so big on me, and you could notice the picture I had when I took with John Glad, the obese beast. You can see like my stomach was a little snug on that. This is a 2X, it's a big shirt. And I could really say that's like a starting point for me. Like when I met John Glad, never in millions of years I ever thought I'll ever create a YouTube channel. Start to vlogging, talking to you guys. I'm in a new path in my life. Seeing the results, like this past 3 months already, like 4 months, I really lost about 60 pounds, and I feel a lot better now, and my clothes fits me better, and I feel like I'm so energetic now than before. I have those days that I don't want to work out. I feel like I don't want to. I just want to stay home and eat and relax. Me personally, I just don't want to go back into my old habits when I was at 300 plus pounds. When I was at 300 pounds, I found my passion. My passion is to lose weight and just to inspire you guys, you know, like what I'm doing. And I got a few friends I know personally, that hit me up about the keto diet. Some of them are on the keto diet too, so I'm really excited and happy for them. And that makes me proud because, like, man, dude, I have to live in my life inspiring others, impacting their lives by just doing what I'm doing. And what I'm doing, I love it. I love working out. I love my diet. Just all around, like, I'm a happy person now. More happier now than before, you know. So anyways, guys, I'm gonna wrap it up here. So if you guys are on the path of losing weight, so if you are interested in doing the keto diet, please let me know in the comment section, or if you know me personally, you can hit me up on Snapchat or my Instagram account, you know, and I'll be willing to help you guys out. And I already have a few people hit me up already. So again, guys, thank you for all the support, for liking and subscribing my channel, and hopefully in the near future I will get more people to subscribe. So anyways, guys, so I'm gonna wrap it up here, and I'm gonna finish editing this video tonight, and I'm gonna upload it tomorrow morning, or if I get up on time. So anyways, so I'm gonna wrap it up here, guys, and I'll see you guys later. So BD Keto out. Bam.